Hey animal enthusiasts and pet hobbyists, it's Joel here, and today I'm going to be giving you a quick Temu haul and reviewing some products for reptiles and invertebrates. Let's get into it. Alright, got my box cutter, now time to open it. It's like opening a Christmas present. Ooh, whoa. All right, first things first, we got our infrared thermometer here. This is going to be useful for checking the temperature in some of our reptiles enclosures and invertebrates enclosures. I already have one, but we're just going to see how this one works out. This is going to be pretty cool. And I just got a few different like plants for some of the decorations. This is going to be a fake plant, but I think it might be nice. All right. We got a little hideaway, naturalistic hideaway. I'm gonna be opening these individually, but yeah, let's just separate everything first. There's a little egg breeding box. I think it's pretty cool. Let's open this. Okay, see what's in here. It's a naturalistic food or water dish. All right, so we got a little mini, it's like a spider enclosure. Pretty cool. Thinking about using this for maybe a jumping spider in the future. Let's see what's in here. Alright, it's like a little bent pipette. Wouldn't really be eating that anyways. I think it's another one of the spider enclosures. Let's see. Yep, here it is. It's pretty cute. Has a little bit of fake greenery in it. And then it also came with a little wood one, which I'm probably going to use. It's pretty cool. And you could just put it in there. And then it also has one more thing. I think there's a little water or food dish. Yeah, so here it is. Looks like sort of like glass, but yeah, it's pretty cute to put water in it. And then I got another one of these enclosures that I have to set up. I'm gonna be setting this up and then I'll show you guys afterwards. And here is another smaller one, I believe. Unless they come together, we'll check about that. Come and see what's in here. Oh, this is just another food dish that prevents the insects from escaping, like mealworms and whatnot. Pretty cool. So yeah guys, after opening all the packages and assembling all of them, this is the Temu haul. So I got this little fake plant, it's kind of flimsy, but I mean it's better than nothing, pretty cheap. I'm probably going to use this for one of the animals. And then I really like this hideout, it looks really naturalistic compared to other stuff I've seen, except for the inside, but yeah, it's really spacey, lots of room, probably going to use it for like a snake or something. And then I also got this little incubation container that you could put eggs in. If you remember, I've bred alligator lizards before. This might make it a little bit more easier and for me to organize. But yeah, you just put it in here. Maybe you could lift this and put some perlite or some sphagnum moss. And I also got this little water dish. It's kind of natural. I mean, the paint's a little bit eh, but it's useful. You could use it for like a small lizard. And then I got this little food dish. It's good especially for like superworms and mealworms because they're constantly leaving. And this little rim at the top prevents them from being able to escape. So this is really useful. Probably I'm going to use it for like my bearded dragon. He'll definitely benefit from that. So for the infrared thermometer, all you really have to do is flip open this little hatch. It has these little like hinges right there that you can remove it from. And insert the batteries like that and close it. And you can turn it on. And should tell you temperature. You could switch off between Celsius and Fahrenheit, and it's pretty cool. So now I'm going to show you guys how I assembled the enclosures that you have to put together. First, you should remove the protective films on each panel, otherwise it will just end up looking blurry. I used a box cutter, but whatever you choose to use, just be careful that you don't damage the panels. Alrighty, so once you got all the protective covers off, this is how it should look aligned. And you could pretty much start anywhere, but you just want to make sure that you're wary with where the top's going to be and the bottom. So I'm going to just start at these sides. You could just start connecting these hinges with the little panels that are right here. So you could just insert like that. And then it came with these rubber bands, and this is what you use to connect them. So it could be a little bit tedious, but it's not too difficult. Just insert and then close it with the band. Just like that. And you can connect it with the bottom. So this is the bottom piece. This one you can go put it on both sides. Then use a band for these. It doesn't give like an instruction on how to connect it or anything, but it's pretty self-explanatory. So you just do it with these sides as well. Just like that. And the last side, do it like that. At the bottom, and then you can use the rubber bands again. This is the top, and as you can see, it has these little hinges, and you just want to make sure that these holes are aligned when you're setting it up, these guys, just so that you can put the top, and it's going to go in just like that. So you align the hinge with the holes to get it in there. It should be like that, and then it closes and opens like that. And then it also has this little magnetic part for it to close, and you just insert it like that, and then put another rubber band. And then it pretty much just closes like that. And then that's pretty much it. Not too difficult. And it looks pretty nice in my opinion. And then I also got this larger enclosure. You pretty much set it up the same way as you did for this one. But yeah, I'm gonna show the end result. All right, so this is the larger enclosure. It's actually surprisingly a lot bigger than I thought it was gonna be. The main difference is probably just the lid. I'm not sure if I put this on right, but it sort of just has this little hinge thing that you could sort of lock it, and then you just remove it, and then pretty much just lift it up the same way, and it has a lot of space, and then you just close this part. It also had this thing that I'm not really sure where it goes, maybe one of the backs, but it also had these little like L hangers that you could probably put maybe a food dish or water bowl. But yeah, it's plenty of room for maybe an arboreal tarantula or small spider. But yeah, pretty cool. So for this guy, basically just open it like this from the top, and then you could put any other decorations like the food or water bowl, and then the sticks, and then just close it like that. And I really don't recommend this for like adult spiders, like jumping spiders and things like that. This is probably more for spiderlings, because I didn't expect it to be so small, but it is really cute, and yeah, probably better for spiderlings. And then this last spider enclosure, again, it's pretty small, more for like spiderlings, maybe a smaller jumping spider. But I noticed that when it came in, it was cracked right here, so that's one thing you probably want to be aware of. Sometimes these guys get moved around the shipment and not in the best, hands. But yeah, to open it, you basically just lift up this little red part and then slide it like that. It has this little like hinge right here that allows it to be locked or secure, and you just put it back like that, slide it in, and it's pretty spacey, more for like less arboreal species because it's not so tall, more cube-like or square-like. But yeah, it's pretty nice. I like the top, the design has a little spider web, and yeah, you can just put whatever decorations, but again, yeah, just a little crack. So this was the larger enclosure I set up, and it also holds loose substrates very well. Nothing falls out. I temporarily added this baby Mexican red-kneed tarantula since I'm planning a future build and video for him. But yeah, that is essentially my Temu haul. If I had to give a rating out of 5, I'd likely give it a 4.8 just because of damages. But aside from that, everything was accurately described, and I plan to use these items. The link for each of the items should be in the description that I'll add if they're still in stock. But yeah, if you like this video, please make sure to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.